A large algae bloom in the Monterey Bay is releasing very high levels of a deadly toxin, and scientists say it's growing. Action News reporter Caitlin Conrad has more live from Monterey right now.
Dan, the toxins from the algal bloom are especially dangerous for marine animals, but scientists say they can also be harmful to humans, which is why they're saying no one should be eating shellfish caught in the Monterey Bay. Researchers say a large algal bloom has taken over the Monterey Bay, growing fast and releasing some of the highest levels of a deadly toxin scientists have seen in years.
We have two ESPs in the water right now, one right out of Monterey and one just south of Santa Cruz. And we're seeing these really high domoic acid levels in both locations, which is very, very unusual. We haven't seen that for 10 years.
The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration is reporting the levels are 30% higher than what is needed to close down shellfish harvesting. Scientists with Mbari say that toxins from the algae bloom are going to have a chain reaction on marine animals, and they say they've already found more dead seabirds on Central Coast beaches.
It can filter water and then put some preservative on that and create an archive.
Jim Birch with Mbari says they are able to track this bloom and changes in the water faster than they have in years past, thanks to a sensor developed by the team there.
This is a one-of-a-kind instrument. Like I say, everyone would have to bring stuff back to the lab and they could do the analysis back at the lab. But doing it autonomously and robotically, this is the only instrument in the world that does that.
The machine you just saw can bring Mbari results almost up to the hour, and that's how they've been tracking this bloom over the last few weeks and most recently as it started to really grow in the last few days. Dan.
All right. Well, the scientist with UC Santa Cruz who has been working with Mbari says the algae bloom is not just in the Monterey Bay where they're recording data. He believes it could go as far north as Washington State and south to Santa Barbara.